When they are ages, then we have to depend upon the wavelet transfer. This was a problem for a long time, and now the people are working, basically engineers, and now mathematicians are also working in this field. The problem is that these are not stationary, they are very smooth tests. So no problem, for a transfer is substrate. For ages, there is a problem, then we have to depend upon the wavelet transform. For that, this theory is developed by basically engineers, not by mathematicians. And main contribution in this field is of Dobyshees. She has also written a book that is by name 10 Lectures on Wavelet. That is a very good book. And there are so many books in the market available. Yes, in the history of mathematics, wavelet chemistry shows many different origins. Much of the work was performed in the 1930s, and at that time the separate works did not appear to be parts of the coherent theory. Before 1930s, let us go to back to the time of Joseph Fourier in 1807. As most of us know, in the scientific world, that he asserted any two bipyramidal function F is the sum. We know all this, so we don't want to discuss. The Fourier's assertion played an essential role in the evolution of the ideas mathematicians had about the functions. He opened up the door to a new functional universe. So this is okay, no problem. However, 1873, in 1873, Paul to Horace Raymond constructed a continuous two-bipyramidal function of the real variable x, whose Fourier series diverged at a given point. This was the problem. When the Fourier series was converged, there was no problem. When the Fourier series diverged, then there was a problem. And also, we know in daily life also, when there is one door is closed, so many doors are open. So this is also in mathematics. When there was a problem, then other solutions came up. Now, at that time, three new avenues were opened to the mathematicians, and all of these have led to important results. First was, they could modify the notion of function and find one that is adopted in certain sense to Fourier series. This was one of the solutions. They both thought it may be possible or not. In this direction, a lot of work has been done. Window Fourier transform and Schrödinger Fourier transform. So many things have been done, a lot of work has been done. Second was, they would modify the definition of convergence of Fourier series. This was another option. In this direction also, Cesar also was given, and a lot of work has been done in regard to the second. And third one, they would find the other orthogonal systems. Instead of first and second, there is also a possibility that there may be some other system. Then they could find other orthogonal systems for which the phenomenon discovered by Raymond in the case of geometric system cannot happen. Now the third route leads to the wavelets. This is followed by Haar. Haar has given in 1908 without knowing that this is a wavelet. That is basically the wavelet. And that is also used for applications. Haar wavelet. The name is given in about 1985. That was the wavelet. Who asked himself this question? Does there exist another orthogonal system given by this? Are functions defined on closed interval 0,1 such that for any function continuous on 0,1, the series converges to F uniformly on a closed interval 0,1? So this is scaling function given by Haar himself, and this is the graph of the wavelet function. And how we write the in terms of that. Now this is the first definition of wavelet, which is due to Gaussmann and Morland. It's quite broad. This is the first definition, admissibility conditions given here. Now the second definition of wavelet is adopted by Littlewood, Cayley, Steen, Thury, and he has given this form. And third one is very, very important and applicable, given by Rupees, and M comes to, a vector is a function side belong to L to R. Inversely depend on the space L to R such that this set of functions is an orthonormal basis for L to R. Such a wavelet necessarily verifies the second condition. So wavelet is nothing but this is a function from N to R. Now, wavelet packets. Wavelet packet is another generalized concept of wavelets. Wavelets sometimes, depending on the problem, because main is the basis, which basis we have to use. Basis is very, very important. So sometimes we use wavelet basis, sometimes we use wavelet packet basis. And it has been found also, we have given an application that we solve the problem by using a wavelet is not very good, but in comparison to wavelet packet transport. So that is better than that. Now, how it is defined, we don't have good detail. And in condition 4, there exists a function phi belonging to V naught such that phi x minus k belonging to z forms a ring space is orthonormal basis for V naught. This condition is very, very important in multi-resolution analysis. And this function which is in V naught, this is known as the scaling function, and also we call it father wavelet. Father wavelet is the beginning of the wavelet. Now we are interested how we find out other wavelets by using father wavelet. So with the help of father wavelet, mother wavelet is obtained first, and after that son wavelet, daughter wavelet, and whole family is obtained. Now, construction of mother wavelet is very, very important, and this is very interesting, which also I have given in our book. If anybody is interested, you can see the detailed report is given. Now, in order to find out the mother wavelet, what we do here, let W naught be an orthogonal complement of V naught. That is, V1 can be written as orthogonal sum of V naught and W naught. Then, what we do here, phi is the function which is father wavelet comes out from V naught, and corresponding to this with the help of father wavelet, in W naught we are getting another wavelet, that is psi, and that psi is known as mother wavelet. So mother wavelet is obtained with the help of the father wavelet. And after that, with the help of father wavelet and mother wavelet, we define wavelet packet, that is the generalized concept of wavelets. And after that, I would like to switch on to applications instead of giving more time. So there are so many things, this piece, feature extractions, I don't want to tell you this. Yes, how we solve the problem of speech signals. Actually, there are signals. Signals are just when I am speaking here, so signals are out. And signal is in crude form. And also, in signals, noise is automatically there in the signal. So, how critical problems are to choose right wavelet in order to solve signal problem? First is to choose right wavelet, means basis. Basis is very important, choice of wavelet, basis. So, when we solve the problem, first of all, the criteria comes, which basis we have to use. There are so many basis given by the machines or other. So, and second, to determine appropriate threshold value. And third is to find optimal level of decomposition. Now, delivering speech signal through wavelet transforms. So, this is the method which I have given. And so, this is the study for the first one, the robust thresholding. And now it is proposed that we have compared, and we have up to some extent. Now this is the signal in A generated by ourselves. Original is speech signal. So first one is the signal generated by ourselves. We have not taken from internet, but just we have the system, and it is say Apple. So signal is generated. So first signal is generated when we speak Apple. If it speaks some other word, another signal will be there. So what we do in this signal, we add here white noise and after adding the noise, we try to extract the noise. This is a problem. So second one is that by addition of adding the noise, and then we try to take out the noise outside. Now this looks like in mathematics. So there's a question to me. So what we're doing here? Nothing. Just x equal to e. So x plus p equal to e plus p, or cancelling p at p, x equal to e is what you've done. So I told you this, now this problem is not like that mathematically. But this problem is if we add water in milk and to separate, it is not like mathematics. It is very difficult to separate. So same problem is also here. When there is a signal, noise is there. So how we should take the noise? That's not being so simple. But we have to use the material and the correct basis we have to use, and then some up to some extent we can get the approximate value, not the exact. If you compare the first one and third one, so you see we are getting approximate value, not the exact value. So this is one problem which we have done. The method is given in the paper that we don't want to discuss. Another is yes, this is another signal. And instead of speaking FL, there is another signal. And let me see the second one. This is noisy speech signal. Noise is there. And the third one is stimulating speech signal that we are taking out by using MATLAB and coding. So what we did here, instead of taking the image from the internet, because from internet, add the noise, problem is very simple, not difficult, it's done. But we thought that there should be our own image. And then we add some noise and we try to extract the noise. For that we have done very recently, and our paper is published in 2014. And that is published in International Journal of Wavelets, Multi-Resolution and Information Processing. So that we are going to discuss here. Actually, this is a slide which is not working. There was a wavelet, how wavelet is generated. Very good video. But this is not working. I don't know what that input is. And there is also here a video where how we denoise the image. So this is also not working. Now, this is the image we have taken. This is the image of a small child, maybe 2.5 years old. This is the original image. And to fix this problem, to fix this image through MATLAB, it was very difficult, and it took 4 months to settle the problem. After fixing this figure, then we add the noise, and then we try to, after decomposition, we have denoise, and let me see, this is the decomposition of truth at level 4. First is this, second, third, fourth. And then finally, we got the original, we have the original image of first and the denoised image the second. So what is the problem here? The problem is that we take the image and then add the noise, then denoising, we are using the MATLAB and dosage 7.0 and then coding, and then we are trying to get the image back. And this paper was sent to the journal. And there was suggestion from the editors that this is a good paper, we can publish only if we add something more. And they gave us 6 months time. And I was very surprised why they have given us 6 months time. 1 month is sufficient. When we started, according to their points given there, then really it took 6 months to improve our paper after they are published. And recently we have received their email. And they told me that your paper is very good, and 186 people have downloaded this paper. And also he has requested that you send us such type of paper again, we will review and publish in our journal. So I am very happy that this paper is published there. And along with this figure, they have given that we had some more figures. Then we decided we had to not generate our own image, but we have taken the, this figure from internet, from Jaipur, Hawa Mahal. And we have added the noise, and then we have decomposed up to level 4, and then we tried to extract the, we have tried to denoise, and I will show you that we are not getting the same image, but this is up to some extent, it is, yes, first one is the original limits and second was the denoised limits. So this time we are working, this paper is published. Recently also we have published a paper which is on applications of wavelet packets in image denoising. So our problem is that, now the problem is that this is the image generated by ourself. We have added the noise. Now what is the solution for we have that the CCTV cameras are there and image is there, but if you see the footage and image is not clear, how you have to denoise? This is a problem. We are working on that. If you have succeeded, I think this will be a very good work in the history of our country. But I don't know whether we will get the success or not. But this is a problem. Take the footage from the camera, CCTV camera. If the figure is clear, okay. If the figure is not clear, then we have to try to denoise the image. So we are working on that. And also similarly, there is another problem, that data compression. In data compression, there is a problem, and this problem can be solved.